So firstly, you're going to go ahead and pick up some hair. I'm using my DY Hair 777 Virgin Peruvian Body Wave Hair. I picked up 4 bundles in a closure in a length 222, 220, and an 18-inch, 5x5-inch lace closure. So here's what the hair looks like, and I really do appreciate the quality of this hair. I'm becoming a really big fan of this company's hair just because it's a really good quality. When they say that it's tangle-free, shed-free, it really is. I haven't had any problems with this hair, and that is the reason why I decided to pick up their body wave hair this time. I'll be sure to link down a coupon code here on the screen so you guys can take advantage of it and save some money off of your purchases if you guys do become interested. So to get started, of course, you're going to need a dome cap, some sewing thread, some sewing needles, some T-pins, elastic band, and measuring tape. However, this is optional. I will not be utilizing that in this video, as well as your hair. You're going to also need a styrofoam wig head and a table support clamp, as well as a pair of scissors. So let's go ahead and get started. So firstly, I went ahead and I secured my styrofoam wig head to the table, and now I am just adding my wig cap. So firstly, you're going to go ahead and sew down your closure, and I'm just going ahead and I'm doing that. There's no really particular way on doing this. There may be some videos that you can look on for a more in-depth way on how to sew down your closures. However, I'm simply just going through the lace around the perimeter of the closure, and each time I go through, I do knot my thread just in case the thread happens to snag or happens to tear. My closure will still be secured down to the wig head without any problems. So go ahead and finish doing that. And this is what the closure looks like once it is properly sewn down.